Isekai.
The Rebirth of the Malicious Empress of Military Lineage, Chapter 29. Confusion. At the male side of the banquet, other than Prince Ding, there were only two princes who attended, Prince Zuo, Fu Ziyuan, and Prince Jing, Fu Ziyuan. The crown prince's health was not good, and would not participate in such an event. Consort Zhu Xian gave birth to Prince Zuo and Prince Jing, and both of their abilities were outstanding. Prince Zuo was much more arrogant, whereas Prince Jing was introverted. Both of them were eyeing the throne, as everyone knew that the crown prince's health was poor, and there would eventually be a day when the emperor would change the crown prince, and consort Zhu Xian had the favor of the emperor. By contrast, Prince Ding's mother, consort Dong Xu, had a much lower profile. If Prince Ding was not somewhat outstanding, she would not be able to sit in the position of the four consorts. In the previous life, Prince Zuo and Prince Jing was entangled in the fight for the throne but relaxed their vigilance on Prince Ding. The first reason being Fu Ziyi was in good relations with the crown prince, and would always walk the same path as the crown prince, and personally find previous medicinal herbs for the crown prince that even the empress was quite satisfied with Fu Ziyi. This made the rest of the people think that Prince Ding was a lackey of the crown prince. The second reason was that Fu Ziyi was usually aloof from politics and material pursuits, and would disdain from participating in the affairs of the court. Besides, consort Dong Xu had a cautious nature, and would spend all day recite Buddhist scriptures. Without strong maternal support, it was expected that Prince Ding was unable to make any waves. But the final one who would sit on the dragon seat was Fu Ziyi, which they think was unable to make any waves. Shen Miao picked up the leaf cards. Just like these leaf cards, the cards in Fu Ziyi's hand were rotten since birth, and everyone thought that he would be eliminated at the beginning, but no one dreamed that he had never thought of using the cards at his hands. His cards are all in other people's hands, and what he needed to do was to snatch them. "Why do you have no reactions?" Seeing her remaining silent, and not even see a trace of admiration to Fu Ziyi in her eyes, Feng Anning felt somewhat strange. "Don't you like him?" Xin Miao raised her head and looked at her. Feng Anning was shocked. That one look made her heart freeze, and she felt the sudden urge to kneel. She did not know where did the feeling came from, but she knew that Shen Miao was not happy with what she just said. She paused and spoke, "Actually, I also do not like him. How can a person be so perfect in the world? It is just unreal." This time Shen Miao took a serious look at Feng Anning. She did not expect that this proud young lady would see it that way. Several people were in love with Fu Ziyi, and if Fu Ziyi was willing, the entire field of young ladies would fall for him. How would there be someone who was able to be that unconventional? She slowly said, "It seems that you have someone in your heart." "What nonsense you are talking about?" Feng Anning's little face suddenly reddened. "Don't falsely accuse a good person." Shen Miao did not continue to speak to her. She did not incline to listen to a little girl's troubles. Naturally, she had her things. After much coming and going, as there many invitations sent out for the chrysanthemum banquet, almost everyone had arrived. Below the Yantang chrysanthemum field, a tall huge stage was built. The stage was decorated plainly, but no one felt that it was vulgar, as the late emperor used it to pray to the heavens. It was a stage that had the air of dragons. Both sides of it were inscribed with personals, and some of them were wearing soldiers' uniforms with red headbands, beating the drums loudly. The sound of the drums rumbled straight throughout the skies as the musician plucked their qin, its song of a virtuous gentleman, which meant to portray the imperial family request, and yearned to pick the true talents for the country in today's academy for the Empire of Ming Qi. The music entered everyone's ears, and due to the Uniq magnificent sound, one would not help but feel the surge of emotion. Most of those present were youth, and they were in a moment where they were hot-blooded. Thus the music made them enter it, and they could not help but show off all their talents to everyone, and fight for a good future for Ming Qi's imperial family to leave being a stroke in history. Even a female could not help but reveal a look of excitement. Although they were unable to become a court official like males, their fathers and brothers were pillars of the country. Their family clan had an indomitable spirit, and with the glory and honor, they would be bathed in the imperial family's favor, and feel their heart full of gratitude. The entire audience was enveloped in the vast and might of the imperial benevolence, and was moved, but there was one person who had a look of indifference, and not a single trace of being moved. Xin Miao's eyes landed on the person who was in the center playing the qin. This is the favorite thing the Ming Qi imperial family loves to do, to incite the hearts of the youth to dedicate themselves to the service of the country, and use them to do rotten stuff for the imperial family. But, at the end, once the country was stabilized, these hot-blooded youths shed blood and sweat would rarely get a good ending. Boil the hound once the rabbit was caught. When every emperor takes over the throne, they would eradicate the older generation of people, especially those officials who had experienced the dark nature of the fight for the throne. After gaining knowledge of the filthy arrangements and bloody events, how could the imperial family be assured for them to rise in their career? This exciting music would only be known as funeral music in the future, as it pushes people to their death, and now immersed in the hearts of the youths who serve the country, would die under the treacherous strives of the imperial family, and become innocent sacrifices. She could not save everyone in the world, but could save her people. Shen Miao raised a hand lightly, and her right sleeve brushed past the edge of the table. That bright teacup was brushed to the ground with a pa sound. The crisp sound resonated in the venue, and it should not be heard, but under the rich rhythm of the music, it sounded just at the right time where the thread was being pulled up, and that messed up the other strings too. With a pa, the rhythm of the music was wrecked. Just like waking from a dream, Feng Anning suddenly recovered, and saw Shen Miao picked up the teacup from the floor as she smiled. "Pardon me, a slip of my hand." Those musicians who were up on stage playing with intensely, had their mind almost blown, and was in so much pain that they almost fainted. Ming Qi had learned this music from the hands of a Western foreigner, and had some intention of confusing others. It could instigate small emotions in one's heart. This piece was a war song, and could amplify the feelings of faith and allegiance greatly. Thus, if this piece was played fully, those who had a loyal heart would become foolishly devoted. It was only when Shen Miao became the empress that she became aware of the hideous nature of the music. The imperial family of Ming Qi used this music to confuse the younger generations, and make these younger generations bleed for them. When the Xiongnu attacked, the imperial family had the Linyu army defend the capital, and recruited a new army to the frontier. They made these musicians go up on stage to play the music, and most of the youths left for the army without looking back, and some of them did not even reach the marriageable age. After such an interruption from Shen Miao, those musicians were unable to focus their energy on their hands, and at the final qin part, it had lost the passion that it previously had, and was just played like an ordinary song. The hot-blooded sentiment that was stirred gradually dissipated, and everything returned to calmness. But, in the end, Shen Miao's move had attracted some people's attention. Over at the dedicated male area, Fu Ziyu Yi and Pei Lang looked over at the same time.